last time there used to be a pub just here. Yeah, it's gone. Now I do believe that it had scaffolding and stuff around it at the time, but when we were here last time, but anyway, it ain't there now. So we just picked the car up, it's 1:45, and we've been told there's a few things need to be sorted, which doesn't surprise me. But at least we're now serviced. Are you going out or what are you doing? No, you're not going out, okay. Something about fuel. That's another thing that needs to be done. It's Monday, the 20th of July. We're just leaving the Thompson River campground. We've got to fill up with water, use a dump point, and fuel up. And we're heading down to Barcaldine. I have an appointment tomorrow morning at 11:30. To have my second AstraZeneca shot. So I've decided to leave early to see if I can avoid some of the crowd. Probably won't, but we'll give it a fly and just drift on down, find somewhere to camp for the night out of town, and then move on into town. Maybe stay at the Ilfracombe or something. We'll see. Get to the Barcaldine early in the morning. Early-ish. Find somewhere to park the car where I can leave it while I go and do the business. And Leslie is coming down tomorrow morning, I believe. She's going to stay for 2 nights at Barcaldine, and then we'll take a run up to Aramac. Possibly up to Matabara as well. Wouldn't mind doing that. So, what's the story? Fuel is dearer here, but at the moment we got a free run. I'll take that. Okay, so we've got our water, we're fueled up. It's quite a warm day at the moment. Beautiful day here in sunny downtown Longreach. tour bus there. I think maybe the train might be coming in today. It might well be. This is the Stockman's Hall of Fame. Did this in 2010, so I spent some money that I really didn't want to spend at the moment, but I don't think we'll be doing it again this time anyway. Right over the road from the Qantas Museum. Qantas Founders Outback Museum. What's more. And just in there is the Cattleman's Bar and Grill. Okay, so it's 12:36 as we've left Longreach and passing the School of the Air. This is Ilfracombe. We're about to pass the kilometre or mile machinery, whatever they like to call it. Hub of the West, it's called, I reckon it's called here. And the caravans are lined up a long way here. Over on the right hand side, I assume that all that standing in between those planes was for the school buses. I'll have to go back to 2010 and dig all my stuff out because I've actually been through all this. Okay, we're going to have a little look around Ilfracombe. There's not a lot here, I don't think, but let's go and see what is here. The road to the left goes out to Aramac. Caravan park area is pretty full. Caravan park's for sale. Little church there. Try truck up there on the thing above the van park sign here on the right. Pretty chockers. One wonders what people who live in a place like Ilfracombe would do for a living or whatever. My goodness. Collect trash, maybe? There's a jag there. Ilfracombe Motors. Let's see. Surveillance for what? I'd be hoping people would take that stuff away. Built in the shed. and building supplies. See? So it's a shed built in the shed. The council chambers. Tennis court there on the left. Steps of Wimbledon. Oh, that looks like we've done Ilfracombe. Yeah, this is school. There didn't seem to be a lot of activity. Well, if you turn the classroom, there won't be all there, but it just doesn't seem to look like a school that's active. A shame it is. Well, we saw all those spots along the front road there. It was shut off from parking, so, or standing, so I guess that was where the school buses actually parked. Antiques and collectibles. It's got a cross on the end of it, so I assume it's a church, but it's, or an old church, ex-church. Back in 2003, Ilfracombe won Tidy Towns competition. I think it would be scratching today, somehow. caravan park, or part of it. Cabins. Unless I'm mistaken, there's a place just along here you can actually pull in camp, but maybe I'm wrong. Oh, something just down here on the right. Yep, plenty of room. Be aware this area is flood prone and boggy when wet. Okay, let's go this other way. There, so if you get in the bloody entries, well then of course people are liable to land on top of you, which is not what we want. It is not what we want. If you enjoyed this video, there's over 200 more just like it on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell, and we'll let you know when our next video is available. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you weren't that impressed, please don't hit the dislike button. Instead, tell us why, so that we can do something about it. Thanks for watching.